What is a common property resource? The way that applied economists think about it, a common property resource is a good that has two characteristics. First, it is rival in consumption, which means that when I take some of it, you can't have that same piece. However, among a defined group of people, it's also non-exclusive, which means that I can't keep you from using it if you're part of the group that is allowed to access it. This idea of a defined user group of a common property resource is important, and the size of that group is also important. Think about a lake full of fish in a world where there are no fishing licenses. If there are only two people who are allowed to fish there, because these two people, say, own the entire shoreline of the lake, then they manage all the fish in the lake together as a common property. If one person catches a fish, it's no longer available for the other person. However, with just two people involved, it's likely that they can come to an agreement about how many fish to catch per season. Now suppose that there's a public boat launch on the lake, and the two people who live there can't stop others from fishing. Now the lake fishery has become open access, and it's likely that the fish population of the lake will get very low as everyone scrambles to try to catch a fish before other people do. There are, of course, many possibilities in between two people and all fishermen. There are many resources in the world that are managed as common property. That is, resources that can be used by anyone within a defined group of people. These include much of the Earth's forest, a substantial amount of pasture land throughout the Americas, Africa, and Asia, and many coastal fisheries. When the group of people allowed to use the resource is small and they communicate well, the management decisions can often be very good for the people and the resource. However, sometimes there are challenges with common property resources when the number of people with access to them gets very big, or they have trouble coming to agreement about how to manage the resource. In this case, we have a kind of market failure, a term we talk about elsewhere in the OSU Dictionary of Applied Economics. Fortunately, there are many solutions to this kind of problem, and if you are a hunter or a fisherman, then you're surely familiar with some of them. That's right, hunting and fishing permits are one kind of government intervention that's meant to help solve over-extraction of resources from a commons that has lots of users. Tradable quotas for ocean fisheries is another such policy. Small resource user groups have also come up with all kinds of creative management systems for common property resources, including limiting grazing to certain areas or certain times of the year, or, in the case of forests, restricting the number of trees each household can take. A common property resource is a resource that's managed by a group of people who each have rights to take what they want. But when one person takes some of the resource, it's no longer available to others. When there are relatively few people with this right, they can often manage the resource without overusing it. However, when there are lots of people with this right, or those people can't come to agreement, then we need an organizing force, like a government or other regulating body, to help make sure the resource doesn't get exhausted.